In this video, we are going to talk about top 10 places to visit in Canada. So before starting this video, please like this video and subscribe to our channel for future updates. From elegant, metropolitan capitals to mountain resorts and marine cities, Canada's cities and towns offer vacationers a broad range of experiences. The greatest destinations to visit may be determined by your interests and the type of vacation you want to take. Vancouver and Victoria, both in the West, offer two quite different perspectives on West Coast cities, yet each has something special to offer. Whistler and Banff are alpine communities where you can immerse yourself in breathtaking mountain landscapes and experience a taste of the great outdoors. Our northern neighbor offers a broad range of vacation locations, from the urban districts of Toronto to the alpine peaks of the Canadian Rockies. It can be challenging to decide which one is ideal for your next vacation. To develop this list of the greatest locations to visit in Canada, US News analyzed various aspects, including affordability, entertainment opportunities, and the range of hotels and resorts, as well as user votes and expert comments. To have a voice in next year's ranking, vote for your preferred location below. Number 10. Vancouver. You can't go wrong arranging a trip to Vancouver if you're looking for beauty, climate, a great atmosphere, and plenty of things to do. This busy city, located on the Pacific Ocean's coastlines and surrounded by snow-capped mountains, is known for its year-round outdoor activities. In the summer, sunbathers may enjoy the beaches, while skiers can enjoy the adjacent ski resorts in the winter. You may walk the seawall or wander through Stanley Park's towering trees at any time of year, enjoy exquisite dining or a casual lunch while watching the sunset, or go shopping, from Granville Island's markets to the city's high-end stores. Take a day excursion from Vancouver to some of the neighboring hotspots such as Whistler, Victoria, or some of the little villages in the mountains or Fraser Valley if you're spending more than a couple of days in the city and looking for some intriguing activities. Number 9. Niagara Falls. The spectacular Niagara Falls, Canada's most famous natural wonder, has been attracting visitors virtually since its discovery. The sight of the massive wall of water crashing over the falls is breathtaking, as is the perspective and access provided to guests. You may literally walk up to the edge of the falls and watch the water disappear over the top, divided only by a cast iron fence. The people and environment created by the falls have had a significant impact on the city that has grown up around them, also known as Niagara Falls. Throughout the decades, stuntmen and daredevils have risked their lives on the falls, resulting in a carnival-like atmosphere that has come to define this distinctive city. Niagara Falls is a short drive from Toronto, and the city is a pleasant spot to visit for a day or two. Number 8. Toronto. Toronto, as the country's largest city, is a cultural hotspot, offering ballet, opera, symphony, and Broadway performances. The CN Tower, a landmark, is also located here. There is no limit to the enjoyment when you combine spectacular shopping, fine food, and fantastic museums. Toronto's waterfront has been undergoing continual expansion in recent years, and currently features attractive walking areas, restaurants, and outdoor concerts and cultural acts during the summer. Beautiful beaches are located just outside the city center in both directions, making them ideal for hot summer days. A public skating rink opens outside City Hall in the winter, and distinctive winter events, such as the popular Winterlicious, add to the pleasure. Ski resorts can also be found near Toronto. Number 7. Montreal. Montreal is a one-of-a-kind city, with a lovely old historic quarter dating from the 1600s and a modern city center with vast underground shops. With cobblestone alleys and wonderful ancient houses, Old Montreal is the main tourist attraction. Montreal is also home to a huge number of fashion designers, and high-end boutiques, as well as small hotels and restaurants, line the old streets. Although Montreal is located in the French-speaking province of Quebec, English-speaking visitors will have no trouble connecting with anyone in the tourism sector. Number 6. Banff. The lovely mountain town of Banff, located within the spectacular Banff National Park, is a must-see for anybody interested in exploring the Rocky Mountains and seeing some of Canada's most beautiful landscapes. This is clearly a tourism town that caters to visitors from all over the world. Lake Louise Ski Resort and Sunshine Village Ski Resort, two of Canada's top ski resorts, are just a short drive from town. The adjacent Blue Lakes, especially Lake Louise, and glacier-capped mountains are a breathtaking sight in the summer. You don't even have to leave town to enjoy a gondola ride to the top of a mountain for supper, swim in a hot springs-fed pool, shop like a local, discover great walking routes, and potentially see elk and woodland caribou that frequent the area. Number 5. St. John's. The ancient and pleasant city of St. John's is located in Canada's far eastern province of Newfoundland and Labrador. Although it is the primary air entrance to the island of Newfoundland, many visitors come merely to enjoy the city. The sloping alleys that go along hills, with views out over the port, are lined with colorful structures. The city also includes a number of historic monuments and attractions, including as Signal Hill and George Street, but the real draw is the dynamic environment, friendly people, and maritime culture that distinguishes it from the rest of Canada. Number 4. Ottawa. Ottawa, Canada's capital, is home to some exceptional national museums and historic monuments, as well as Parliament Hill, and it is situated along the Rideau Canal in a picturesque location. It's also a tiny city, so it's easy to get around and explore. Summer is a great time to visit because there are so many activities going on, such as the Tulip Festival in the spring and the typically lavish Canada Day celebrations on July 1st. When the weather is cold enough in the winter, the canal is transformed into a 7.8-kilometer-long skating rink, and the annual Winterlude events in February bring large crowds. There is never a terrible time to visit Ottawa, which is only a few hours away from Toronto by car or train. Number 3. Whitehorse. A trip to Whitehorse allows visitors to see life in Canada's extreme north. This is the Yukon's capital as well as a gateway to locations further north, such as Alaska and the stunning Nahanna National Park. Prospectors passing through on their way to Dawson City during the Klondike Gold Rush left their mark on the city's history. Many of the city's attractions provide insight into the Gold Rush era, and there are also magnificent natural sites to explore beyond the municipal limits. The night sky may come alive with a display of northern lights if you're lucky. Number 2. Whistler. Whistler has long been regarded as a world-class ski destination, hosting many of the skiing events at Vancouver's 2010 Winter Olympics. Whistler, despite its notoriety, is an equally beautiful and popular summer destination, offering hiking, bicycling, golfing, and a variety of other activities. The settlement has evolved over time to become a thriving, high-end resort town with a diverse range of hotels, restaurants, and shops. Whistler Blackcomb is known for its magnificent terrain, which attracts skiers from all over the world. The Peak to Peak gondola connects the two summits and is open to skiers and non-skiers year-round. It is an 11-minute, 4.4-kilometer journey with amazing views. Number 1. Tofino. The small town of Tofino on Vancouver Island, Canada's unofficial surfing capital, is one of the most unusual destinations to visit in the country, attracting a diverse throng of visitors. People come to Pacific Rim National Park to surf, hike in old-growth forests, and enjoy the beaches, to see wildlife, to kayak, to stormwatch in November, and to relax at one of the small seaside lodges. The town itself is small and has an end-of-the-world air to it, but great eating can be found at a few of the lodges and restaurants in the area. The town has a distinct personality thanks to a small number of shops, galleries, and coffee shops. Despite its modest size, the town has a large feel to it. With so much to see and do, you'll want to spend at least a few days here, though a week or more is easy to fill. Another little village near Tofino is Ucluelet, which you may easily visit on an adventure from Tofino. What do you think of our video? Let me know in the comment section below. If you enjoyed this video and want to hear from me again, be sure to hit that subscribe button before you go. Thanks for watching.